other. If it's not the lack of content, it's the SBMM. If it's not the SBMM, it's the lag. If it's not the lag, it's the doors. If it's not the doors, it's Joe Seacott. If it's not Joe Seacott, it's David Vonderbald. And now, if it's not David Vonderbald, it's cheaters in both Warzone and now multiplayer. Ass Division. Do something other than nothing. Yo, what's going on, guys? It's the boy Fooly, and I'm bringing you guys another video right here on Black Ops Cold War. Today, unfortunately, we're talking about cheaters in Cold War, Warzone, Modern Warfare 2019. But before we get into anything, make sure to leave a like on this video if you enjoyed, subscribe if you're new, and let's get right into it. You know, occasionally when I hop on Twitter and I do a simple search for Cold War or anything Call of Duty related, you know, there's sometimes where I can't believe my eyes and sometimes where I'm just not surprised whatsoever. Well, pretty much, if you guys haven't heard, over the last couple of days, apparently some filthy creep living in the crevices of his mother's basement has started developing a brand new cheat that's coming into Cold War. You can use it in Warzone, and I think you can use it in Modern Warfare 2019. All I'm gonna say is, I don't need cheats, all right, guys? I do not need cheats. But apparently, these new cheats that are coming out for console only, apparently, they give you, like, extra aim assist, I think. I didn't spend too much time looking at this specific cheat. Trust me, there's plenty of other garbage on Twitter that I could be looking at. Cheats for Cold War multiplayer console only is not something that I really want to spend my time looking at. I guess it's a new program that you can put into your game that gives you extra aim assist, and you're allowed to tweak with the amount of aim assist that you have. So I guess, theoretically, you can set your aim assist to like normal, and if you really wanted to, you could set your aim assist on like virgin mode, where you're essentially just walking onto people. I guess the bright side to this, if you even consider this a bright side, this isn't a wall hack. You can't see people through walls. You know, you're not a super virgin, you're just a regular virgin if you use this, and they'll essentially highlight somebody that's on your HUD, so you actually have to be seeing them on your screen, and you get this whole big blue box around their body so you can see them clearly. I'm not even gonna bother showing the footage of this thing. Personally, I don't think this thing deserves any sort of attention unless it's negative attention. I mean, unless you plan on completely roasting the ever-living dog shit out of people who use this or who make this, which I completely plan on doing, then I'm not even gonna bother linking this video, showing any footage from it, showing any pictures from it, showing any tweets from it. I'm sure you guys could find that stuff yourself, but just a quick warning, it's pretty horribly edited. I'm not gonna lie, guys, the video promoting this thing really looks like the trailer to a really bad B-rated action film from like the 1960s. I mean, like, it looks really, really bad. Like, I'm not even gonna lie, guys, I'm pretty sure my f***ing grandma can come up with a better video promoting this garbage. But that's enough of roasting the video of the cheat and the cheat itself. Now I'm gonna start roasting the people who use said cheats. And please, guys, excuse my French in this video, but if you use cheats in any video game, but especially if you're using it in Call of Duty, in a game that's already trash, then please, with all due respect, if you are using these cheats, please suck my balls, suck my c*** and tug on my scrotum at the same time. Personally, I don't think you deserve thumbs to even hold a controller. And I'm not gonna lie, guys, and I'm pretty sure a few people might not like what I'm about to say right now, but I'm not a big fan of playing PC COD. Like, personally, I just don't like the idea of being able to use your wrist, forearm, elbow, and entire goddamn shoulder into a mouse and keyboard to help you aim in COD. Listen, that's just my opinion, alright? If you do it, I don't hate you or anything. And as a matter of fact, if you're using a cheat on console in Call of Duty multiplayer, not even in Warzone, you might be the worst breed of them all. Like, you actually might be the worst breed of players in Call of Duty history. You're worse than the Phase 5 guys, you're worse than the mousepad PC fellas, you're worse than the Joe Seacott goo cheaters. You are actually in a tier of your own, below everything, below my f***ing grandma. My f***ing grandma can probably outplay you, I'm not gonna lie. You are worse than the player base that Modern Warfare 2019 and Joe Seacott catered to. And again, excuse my French, but you can quite literally grab on my horse-sized ball sack and tug on my nuts as you suck my cock. Personally, I can't imagine how horrible you need to be at a video game to actually acquire cheats in it. And I'm not talking like GTA Vice City PS2 cheats where you like mash a bunch of buttons on your controller and all of a sudden you have God mode and you turn into a goddamn helicopter. And these aren't even the only cheats people have. We still have aimbot, wall hacks, infinite UAVs, Cronuses, which if you don't know what that is, it pretty much is a device that you connect to your your controller, and it gives you zero recoil. Now, personally, I think a lot of Warzone streamers have that. I'm not gonna say any names, but personally, that's just how I feel. And then there's a few things that some people don't consider cheating, but I personally do. Things like reverse boosting, joining up on easy accounts for your SBMM, using different VPNs and net dumas, all of those things I consider cheating. If you are altering the game in any way whatsoever, whether it be the servers, your controller, the other players on the enemy team, anything, and you use it to your advantage, that makes you a cheater. Again, guys, I come from an era in Call of Duty where if you suck, you just suck and you have to get better, and that's all you have to do. You know, this new generation of COD players, like, I swear, there's so many shortcuts that people can take nowadays. And what sucks is I expect these cheats in Call of Duty, I'm not gonna lie. I think every single Call of Duty up to this point has had cheaters, many cheaters too. But that's after its life cycle is already over. If you go back to play Black Ops 1 or Black Ops 2 or MW2 or MW3, those lobbies are filled with cheaters. Even if you go back to Black Ops 4, there's some cheaters in there. You don't expect it midway through the game's life cycle. And what's even worse is what I mentioned earlier. On this specific cheat that's going viral right now, you can pretty much adjust your aim assist. You can set your aim assist to just slightly higher than what it normally is. So theoretically, yes, you can actually just barely tune your aim assist. That guy got shitted on. To the point where it's barely noticeable, but it is there, and nobody will know because it's just slightly better than what it normally is. And then we have Ass Division. These people might actually be the most deadbeat developers I have ever seen in my life. Like, I'm honestly pretty sure the people who developed Tetris back on like the Nokia, they probably had better developers than Cold War, Modern Warfare 2019, and Warzone does right now. And just a quick question for anybody who plays Warzone. How many times have you seen somebody talk about anti-cheat? Whether it's your friend, whether it was yourself, whether it was a big ass streamer, how many people have talked about anti-cheat? And Ass Division is yet to do a single thing about it. Yes, there's ban waves every now and then. Apparently, they ban over hundreds of thousands of accounts, which I honestly think is cap. But even then, how many times do you run into a hacker? I play Warzone a lot more frequently than I used to now. And for me, I think every other session, I'm running into a handful of hackers. People with aimbot, people who could see me through walls, people with zero recoil on a naked MG82. Like, do you realize how obvious it is when people are hacking? And catch this, guys. How much do you think it is to install an anti-cheat into your game, or to make a program for PCs so all PCs have to have it if you want to run Warzone? Well, if you're a sensible person, then you'd probably say, well, hey, you know, that doesn't exactly sound all that cheap. It's probably actually pretty expensive. And I'm not gonna lie, it probably is very expensive. Well, luckily for us, our publisher, Ass Division, they are currently worth billions of dollars. And what's crazier to think about is you could be one of the players that consciously pays $20 for a skin in Cold War or in Modern Warfare 2019. You know, you get your sprays, your stickers, your car horns, your vehicle skins, you know, all the stuff that shouldn't equate to $20, but you still pay $20 for. I wonder where all that money's going to. If you thought for a second that that money might go towards an anti-cheat in the future, well, then you might be disappointed to hear that we're probably never gonna get anti-cheat in Cold War or in Warzone, or in the future COD titles. And you know, guys, at this point, it kind of just sucks that every other day we're essentially playing Wheel of Fortune, or I guess Wheel of Unfortune in this case, as to what kind of BS are we gonna see today in COD. You know, one day it could be an abundance of SBMM, one day it could be the horrible servers, the horrible ping and the lag, the next day your console can be bricked, and I guess now there's cheaters everywhere. Not only in Warzone, but in multiplayer. That's gonna do it for me today, guys. I don't really wanna talk about cheaters anymore. I feel like I'm gonna get a hemorrhoid if I keep on talking about this. I'm curious to know what you guys think about all this cheater drama going on in COD right now. Do you have any expectations that Ass Division is gonna do anything about this? Personally, I don't, but I'm curious to know what you guys think. And as always, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Hit that bell notification if you want. And yeah, guys, it's been the boy Fooly. Have yourselves a good one. Cheaters and f*** Joe Seacott, I'm out of here. Toodaloo. This ain't even my body. Hey.